houses and 137 councillors in the city of Cape Town.
Well, this in the wake of yesterday's full council vote that stripped Mayor Patricia de Lille of all her executive powers, reducing her role to a ceremonial one.
The party says that the vote was in contempt of a recent Cape High Court ruling that the status quo remains, pending a full bench sitting into the de Lille DA matter.
The full council sitting descended into chaos. Many opposition parties accused the DA of fighting party politics in council. The Al Jamahar party is taking it a step further, laying criminal charges against all those involved in stripping the mayor of her executive powers.
This item on the agenda stripped the mayor of all her powers and just allowed her to wear the mayoral chain. So if she now wants to make any decisions, she's got to get consensus amongst 20 MAKO members. And if they can't reach consensus, then she's got to call a full council meeting of 210 councillors. Now you can't run a city like that.
The speaker insists the council item was above board.
The item that was tabled in front of council was legally compliant and it was signed off by the city's legal department. I'm quite happy that the item was legally compliant and that Al Jamahar can go the legal route and let us see what the outcome will be.
De Lille has also warned of its negative impact on service delivery.
I just know that it's going to have devastating effects on service delivery. Like I said, service deliveries on the streets is not in the boardrooms. Because every decision now where there's not consensus need to be escalated to a full council meeting. So we're going to have a lot of MAKO meetings. Don't agree and MAKO, then we must call a council meeting. And that is certainly going to delay service delivery.
De Lille's membership was earlier rescinded by the DA, which then also removed her from the mayoral seat. She successfully contested it in court. The judge ruled that she remained in her position until all her matters were heard. A full bench sitting is scheduled for next week. Nomawethu Solwandle, SABC News, Cape Town.